What's her name?
She doesn't have a name. She's number 123.
I suppose the first thing to decide is how you will style yourself. Victoria is hardly the name for a queen.
From now on, I wish to be called Victoria.
Queen Victoria.
It is a shame you don't have a bigger head, Trina. It is too small for the crown, I think.
I remember thinking my uncle's crown would be too big for me.
I have drawn up a list of reliable maids of honor, ma'am. None of them above average height.
Every time he laughed at me for being short, you laughed with him. Every time he told me I was young and foolish, you agreed.
You don't think I'm too short to be dignified?
We're every inch a queen.
People will whisper about you. They remember your grandfather.
But he was mad.
What are you saying, Mama?
How sharper than a serpent's tooth it is to have a thankless child.
I was not expecting visitors.
Evidently.
You, Mrs. Melbourne.
Ready? One, two, three.
For me, this is not a marriage of convenience.
I think it will be a marriage of inconvenience. You once told me that when I gave my heart, I would give it without reservation.
Yes, I remember.
But you cannot give it to me.
And you were almost right.
May I kiss the bride?
I solemnly promise. I have wronged you, Lady Flora.
Yes, only God can forgive you.
It's all my fault.
I've been selling your gloves to the pickers.
Why shouldn't you sell them? As queen, if it's known that I support abolition...
Well, I'm sure the Liberals would applaud your good sense and the Tories would think I'd filled your head with bunkum.
And if I insist, such things may have been necessary in the reign of Elizabeth. But I would like my reign to be a merciful one.